Beverly, it is so good to see you, old friend. How are you?
Good to see you again.
You are clearly hella.
I am hella.
You are hella cool. I'm holding this incredible headdress, which I didn't know that I was allowed to touch until you told me I could pull it off the wig head there.
Oh yeah, show and tell, yeah.
Tell me about this costume. It is totally amazing. I'm seeing textures, I'm seeing really cool techniques. Let's start with a headdress.
Oh, of course, yes. So I'm Hela from Thor Ragnarok. And I fell in love with her character because she's nice and evil, but she's just the coolest evil.
It is a really cool
design is amazing.
It's like, it's mythological how sort of scary this headdress is.
Yes, yes. And I think they did a great job designing it. It's pretty close to the comic version. And Andy Park is the designer, and I just love his stuff. It's just amazing.
And it also looks almost impossible to build, and yet you built it.
Yet I did it. Yeah, I wanted it to be really light, so I used EVA foam for all of these. And the whole thing, when I'm wearing it on my head, weighs less than 2 pounds.
Whoa.
Yeah.
I mean, it is quite light. Yeah. May I?
Of course.
Okay, I don't want to stab anybody. Oh my gosh. My ears.
I know, your ears have to kind of tuck in a little bit.
Yes, it's meant to be worn with glasses. Not many people know that, but the original was the, yes, I feel like killing people. It's great. Not that bad.
And if I may, adjust the horns just a little bit. Of course, yeah. I made these so that I could take them off and I could adjust them for maximum evil.
Depending on your mood.
Yes, because sometimes her horns go forward for like evil. And then sometimes they're up. Yeah.
See, this is the kind of details that only the serial obsessive is going to note.
That is me.
So when you meet the designers, you must be pointing out things that they're like, no one noticed that.
Okay,
I'm gonna take this off. It's magnificent. I can't believe how light it is. And I can't believe you built it all additively.
Yes, and all of the horns come off. There are coat hanger wires. Yep, magnets and PVC pipe to plug it all in. And I wanted to have it modular so I could travel with it. And so that I could also take it off and move around a con and go from A to B. So when I'm taking it off, I look like the Tick because these two are the only ones that don't come off. So they're sticking up on my head.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. Okay, I'm gonna put this back on the head. Okay, tell me about this. I'm seeing what looks like some actual printed texture onto fabric, and you did that print. Tell me about the construction.
So I am very obsessive with detail, and her suit is, of course, 3D printed or something, so I couldn't do that. So what I did was I found heat transfer vinyl, and I ironed all of this. I cut it out with my Cricut, because you know, I'm a big fan of the Cricut.
Yeah, I love the Cricut.
I cut them all out and ironed them on by hand.
These little textures.
Yep, so it's completely like kind of seared onto the
And it's on
fabric,
a, is this like a four-way stretch?
Yep, it's a four-way stretch that I got at a fabric store.
Well, this is really, one of the cool things is about, not many people might realize, but the superhero costumes that are currently being made include tons of extra texture printed on and layers of texture to add these details. And it's 100% convincing. I'm looking at something that does not look like dance fabric.
Right, and I love it. It kind of has a sheen to it Yeah.
And now tell me about these green overlays. This is a rubber.
So this is silicone. Mm-hmm. And so my process for this is pretty interesting. So this is Dragon Skin silicone from Smooth On. I made my master molds with EVA foam. Mm-hmm. And then I usually make a silicone mold, but because I was pouring silicone and I needed so many molds, silicone will stick into a silicone mold unless you use a ton of release, which is hard to clean off.
Yeah.
And I have only over 90 pieces that I had to mold individually.
And like these are all flat molds, am I right?
They're all flat molds.
Okay.
So I made resin molds and I used silicone as a release agent.
Nice.
Yeah.
So that painting.
Had to think about lots of trial and error. It took me 8 months to make the first one. This is the second round. But yeah, so I made these out of dragon skin silicone, which is great because it's got a really, really great stretch.
The stretch on dragon skin is kind of unparalleled. We used it for one of our busters at one point because it was so resilient. And even like we couldn't even burn it with a torch.
Oh.
Yeah, just so in case you want to know.
In case I need to light this costume on fire.
And it's like, so it's super resilient. In a costume like this, where you're putting your arms through and it's very form-fitting, you could easily tear other materials.
Yes. Yes, and so the silicone has been moving really well with my body, which is what I wanted to have. I didn't want to have something sewn onto a bodysuit. because I really wanted that textile feeling on my suit while I'm walking around being evil Hella. Because I didn't want to paint anything onto a suit. I didn't want to sew it, and I didn't want to put foam. And it was just I was struggling with that. So I arrived at the silicone solution, and these are glued onto the fabric with another product from Smooth-On called Silpoxy.
I love Silpoxy.
And you've used that. Yes.
Yes.
It's been so great, and I've been able to tint it. Most of these are all tinted. You can't really tell, which is a good thing, which is why I tint it. But yeah, I use it like contact cement. And it worked really well.
Amazing.
So far.
You sewed the whole base suit yourself, yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I mean, I assume at this point you've got very good patterns of yourself.
Well, the trick with this one was I wanted to hide a lot of the seams underneath the silicone. Mm-hmm. So it's not a standard bodysuit.
Oh.
Yeah, so I made a duct tape dummy, and then I patterned out with tape where the designs were going to go. And then when I lifted those patterns off, I was able to see where those were. And so I made the custom bodysuit pattern from that. So like my knees are, there's like a seam right here. There's a little seam that goes around the side, but see, I don't know if you can tell, there's a little
very, very
seam
minor
that goes there.
Yeah.
So it's, I mean, I see it. But someone from 10 feet away might not see it, but I see it.
But this is the kind of thing that a Hollywood costumer would also go through to hide all. The director would say, I don't want to see seams. And you've really done a tremendous job hiding. And tell me about the shoes.
Well, the boots are integrated into the...
Oh, yeah, they are.
Yeah. So that was another thing that I was really adamant about doing.
You're a glutton for punishment.
I really am. So there's a little zipper in the back so I can get my foot in there. Mm-hmm. The challenge was to make sure that it wasn't too long or too short.
Right.
Because I didn't want to overstretch or have too much sag. So there's a lot of
You end up gluing right to the edge of the sole?
Yep, with barge. Wow. So I glue the fabric to it with barge black cement, and then the rest of it with the Silpoxy.
When you're gluing, just a technical question, when you're gluing barge between two surfaces that is a compound curve, the biggest difficulty I have is matching the stretch from one side to the other as I'm going without ending up with any bubbles or wrinkles. So do you have a resist technique or something?
I do. Actually, I had to do that for the toes on these shoes. Mm-hmm. I would start on my center seam, and I would pin everything in, and I would just do a little bit at a time. So I'd do maybe the leave the middle for the last part. So so if I had to stretch. And
so you're not doing one coat, the other coat, and then just whoosh, your piece.
Yeah.
That makes so much more sense. I'm so impatient.
Yeah, each boot took me about an hour to glue down.
It's fantastic. And it looks more comfortable than your standard cosplay that I've seen you wear.
It's, yes. Yes, exactly. Yeah, it's very comfortable. Even when I have the helmet on, or when I did have it on, it was very, very comfortable because it's so light.
Right.
The only thing I had to watch out for was clotheslining everybody.
Blinding people.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, trying to walk through a con with that is terrifying.
It was really hard, which is why they come off. But I coated everything with Epsilon Pro, which was really great. There's about 5 layers of Epsilon Pro on there,
and
which
is
great.
That's a clear, flexible...
It's semi-flexible. Mm-hmm. It's an epoxy. It's like a two-part. I think it's two parts. And when you mix it up, you can dye it. And you can also sand it. So I coated it right onto the EVA foam and sanded it down and did that again a couple of times. And then the tips, none of the tips are broken on it because there's so many. Yeah, and that was the thing I was really worried about was, you know, dropping. I've dropped them. I've dropped them. And, they've been fine. Yeah.
Also, it is funny, isn't it, how much a gloss coat can hide crimes?
Yes.
Like your eye goes to the shiny part and doesn't notice the...
yes, absolutely. Yeah, I was very happy to see that it was a glossy surface, and I was able to fill in some of the little mistakes.
The little nernies.
Yeah, and it's a black gloss, so it's not like a chrome gloss where you see every single detail.
So now I know that one is never fully done with a costume, but you said you did 2 iterations of this. Is this the last one, or might you dive in again?
There's a dark version. So this is the version that's been going around in the museums when they have the costumes on display, which is why this one looks a little bit different than the ones that you can buy in a store, because the one they buy in the store is closer to the one that they actually CGI'd onto her body.
Oh.
So there's a little bit of a difference. So I'd love to maybe make that one as well as maybe a fun Hello Kitty or something for Dragon Con. Maybe, if I could get around to that. I mean, what a great
costume
for Dragon Con.
You're absolutely right.
We'll see.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Oh, Beverly, it is always inspiring to see your work. Thank you so much
Thank
for bringing
so
this
much.
Amazing creation.